Hey guys, Warchild V1 here, back with some more 7 Days to Die. Alright, so it's about to be morning. We're just letting the zombies know that we're still here. Now, actually doing this will give me, I believe, more mining skill. The more you use this tool, the more it counts as mining, I believe. So, you want your mining skills to go up. That's for sure. The better your skills, the better you are at breaking stuff, the more materials you get out of it. I believe I've mentioned that before. Okay. So we're cinched, but it doesn't really matter. I've already put away the majority of my items, stuff that I'm not going to need. Let's scrap that. Let's put those away. I'm going to go ahead and, well, we'll carry the feathers on us. Alright, we're getting ready to head out for the day. There's that Sims music, which means it is morning here in Naviskane. I always craft my way to get back in before I leave. Because if you don't, if you come back in a hurry, it's going to suck trying to build that to get back in. I guess let's go bust down this back door. I hear zombies inside, by the way. See, I think they're inside. The problem is, yeah, he's right there. In this game, sometimes they sound super close even when they're really not. But he really was pretty close. Hit him in the head. He is not really dead. Now he's dead. A fatty. These are the guys that are a little harder to kill. Cooking pots, cooking pots. They used to be way easier to find. They've kind of fixed that. Yeah, they've made that a little harder now. Let's see. Let's go up in the attic real quick. It's pretty dark, sorry about that. Some ammo on a dead body. And a door, but it has metal on the door. I should probably pull out a torch when I'm in a place like that so you can actually see. I don't know how well you guys can see. I could see enough, you know. Just gonna break this garage door so we can get out. There's a bookshelf in there. Where's this big dude at? There he is. Oh, I missed. Good night. Go to sleep. See, as you see, he takes a lot more hits than some. Got him. He's a bloated walker with his butt in the air. Definitely not going to find a cooking pot in here, but you never know. I mean, I could find some good schematics or something. For a while there, they made us find schematics to make a forge, and that really, really sucked, needing schematics for a forge. That was kind of pushing it, because you need a forge. Hunting knife book. We're going to go ahead and read it. With the hunting knife book, now we can actually build and repair hunting knives, which I'm carrying a hunting knife. Paper. Alright, let's get out of here. I guess we could search the whole neighborhood. Let's see if we can chase this pig down till he dies. I was gonna say, if we're lucky, he'll get stuck in a car. My blunt weapon skills aren't that great yet, but there, we killed him. We need hide. So you want to use a knife or a bone shiv or something to chop them up. You get way more stuff out of them. We got 8 animal hide. Dude, all I need is 20. If we can find a couple more pigs, then that would be pretty awesome, because then we could go ahead and build a forge and just make all the items that we need. I don't know what those gaming tokens are actually for at the moment. I've only heard speculation of what they will be for someday, but the, you know. I hear walking. Sounds to me like an animal, but, you know, it could just as likely be a zombie. No, it's him. He's just chilling at my house. Let's go see if we could find this rabbit that died down here. He ran into a cactus, and I heard him scream, which that's what they do when they die, or when they get hit, but rabbits die easily. In which case, he would be laying next to one of these. That's a bloater. A bloater crawler. And right now, there's a picture of a nose down in the bottom left. That's because I'm carrying meat on me. I'm carrying raw meat. If it's cooked, they still smell it. I'm missing his head. That's what's taking so long here. But it's hard to swing a club and hit him in the head when we're in the grass. There we go. He did. He dead. And he had a can of salmon on him. So I'm not seeing any rabbits. But then again, I might not even be as far out as he was. I don't know how far out we were when I heard the rabbit squeal on the way home last night. We have ears of corn growing here. Yeah, doesn't really matter. What we really need is any animals. Even if it's dogs, I guess. Let's go ahead and pull up the map. Dogs don't give us a lot, but over this way, if we hit triangle, quick waypoint, over that way, we'll definitely find dogs. That's that big, I don't know what it is, a neighborhood, I guess, or something. And I saw a dog while I was there. So Dogs will give us animal hide. Just not much, because their skin's all tore up and stuff. So you don't get a whole lot off of a dog. But you get something. And that would just bypass us having to find the items that we need. Let's look in this house. I'll say a lot of these houses, the doors are unlocked. But these houses, there ain't much of shit, is there? There's nothing in there. Take the painkillers, though. We could always use more pain pills, even if we have enough. Fucking bear. Nope. I am not down for trying to attack a bear yet. We need a hunting rifle, a good hunting rifle, and then we could kill a bear. Not just any old hunting rifle, though. It's got to be some good numbers. I'd say a 400 or up. Get it up in the purple, maybe. Or blue, at least. Bears are just... they are hard animals to kill. Be cool if we just saw another pig. Because one plus with a pig is I can run as fast as they can. If we're going downhill, I can really catch up to them. And they give plenty of meat and hide and all that. Deer, at this point in the game, it's luck if you kill a deer. Because they run like crazy. When you shoot them. Corn seeds, no thank you. Yeah, they run and hop and frolic. I don't know. Deer are just, they are hard to catch. But once you get a good hunting rifle, you could one-shot a deer. But you need a good one first. Alright, we're almost to this little town that we were at earlier, where we saw the edge of it, but I want to get there so I can kill a dog or two. Sounds very inhumane. These dogs are not good dogs, trust me. Let's repair my weapon first. Throw that away. Alright. I need to get more wood while I'm out, also. You could always use lots of wood. Construction tools! I'm getting better. They call this construction. God, I'm used to having at least iron. This house looks exactly like the last one. With iron, dude, I can get 1,000 wood so fast. It's taken me a long time to get, you know, 300. It's still pretty early in the morning. We're doing just fine on time, so... I'm just gathering some wood because you could always use it. Again, if you get lots of wood at night, you could just sit there and craft weapons all night, and then the next morning you'll be better at it because that's what you did. I'll take the oil. This actually feels slow searching, I guess because my level 60 character or whatever has already leveled up plenty. Ooh, I'll take the jars. Let's kill her. Ooh, that lag there for a sec. I'm not quite sure exactly why their bodies slide down after you hit them. The only reason I could think is, if you're next to a wall, you kind of knock them into the wall. I would get that, but I don't even know how to make a magnum. We gotta find instructions on that. Only thing I could think of is if they fall into a wall, then that slides them out to where they're not inside the wall anymore. We don't need any lead yet. This cap, we can actually scrap it. And this shirt, we can actually scrap it. And this metal, we can actually scrap it. Alright, let's keep going. So I hope this series is at least halfway interesting for you guys. I do talk a lot, but I guess that's kind of what you got to do when you're making videos. I just like to speak what's on my mind, and this is the kind of stuff I think about the whole time is, you know, what I got to do, what's next, where to go. And at this point, I'm already thinking, instead of looking for a cooking pot, we just need to make a forge, and then we'll be good. In which case, then glass will actually be useful. You know, I've been not picking up glass and stuff. You can actually melt down sand and get glass. It's weird, but you can melt down glass and get glass. You can make bottles and stuff with it. Alright, we should really be coming up on that neighborhood here soon. And sometimes dogs can be your worst enemy, but if you have a decent iron-reinforced club or spiked club or something of the sort, then you'll be alright. As long as it's not like a lot of dogs or a bunch of zombies surrounding you. Perishton. I've actually never searched Perishton before. That's a weak-ass barbed club. It's raining. It just started. We'll be able to make barbed clubs one of these days. Until then, give me the dogs. There's metal. If you really need metal, you can come here and beat these up, I guess. You get 3 pieces out of it, I believe? Yeah. If you have an actual pickaxe, you just smack it once. And you get 3 pieces of metal. Stay away from the cop. Cop's like the worst freaking zombie so far. Later on, there's worse, but I don't think the feral zombies are actually here yet. I think they'll show up after we've survived a little longer. I could be wrong on that, though. I'm just pretty sure that that's how it works. There's like a baby crying sound. That's a newer sound that they've been using, is a baby. Joey's used car lot. Oh yeah, stone axe. Thank you. Someone else learned how to make a stone axe just like I did. Scavenging leveled up. This might be a place to get more barrels. Looks like a bank or something. Bank gas station. It looks like a gas station. I guess not. Oh, that would make sense if it were a bank. Wait a minute. That was already falling before you flew. You crazy airplane. One thing I've learned, if you don't plan on going to it right away, pull up your map, find the drop, and mark it. Because it's going to disappear off your map soon. And if you already have it marked, you'll be good. I don't want to go to it yet. Goodbye. No, I don't want to go. I want to kill dogs. I want to kill, you know, evil dogs. Where's the evil dogs at? Door would actually be really hard to break. Please fresh water. My guy is like really thirsty. I don't want to drink this lake water that I have. That's like last resort, but actually, there's like chicken stock or something. Let's go ahead and drink whatever that was. Can of stock. That helped a little. Not very normal for us to find all these unlocked doors in a house. Usually if a house has an unlocked door, then they're all unlocked in that house, but most of the time they're not unlocked like this. We'll just knock on the door until they let us. I love the new weather effects. That didn't used to be a thing. One thing I don't really like that they changed, for a while you were able to crawl under wrench schematics read for sure. For a while you were able to crawl under that, and you can't crawl under that. What I'm going to do is break in here in high hopes they'll have some vitamins, in which case I could drink all the lake water I want and then just take some vitamins. Which cures... No, but they have a splint. I'll take the water. We can leave the human turd. I used to be able to crouch and go under this, but... They fixed that. Why would they want you to be able to go under stuff? It was so much nicer. Cooking pot. Alright. I'm gonna take this wrench. We got two cooking pots. Three cooking pots. And some water. Let's go ahead and drink that. Take these 11 empty jars. Alright, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and just get out of this town then. No. We're going to roam through the town a little more and try to find a dog. Because that's the one form of hide that will actually come to you. All the other forms of hide run away from you. All the rabbits and everything else runs away. Dogs, they come right to you. Leveled up, level 4. Good stuff. We have 5 more skill points. Ooh, give me these. Never know when you need to blow shit up. Don't need any brass yet. Where is it? Right there. I will take all the barrels, please. If I could freaking aim. Don't need fishing weights. That's a metal door. Yeah, screw that. Wait till you have the proper tool for the job. Or we could just blow the door open. There's not going to be a whole lot in there for us to do. The problem is there will be like a wall safe, and without the proper tool, opening the wall safe is really hard. Let's run down to the airdrop and I guess head home, and we can start at least boiling water. We're not starving or anything, so we're doing okay on that front. Still like to find an animal. But I have a feeling that's going to be a no-go for right now, at least. Again, deer? Deer would just be way too hard. Damn, we must be close to this thing for it to still be on the map. Yay for a river! We got more bottled water. Just nasty water. We don't want to drink it. I've had people ask me before, how do you fill water? You just pull your left trigger. Or if you're on PC, right click. But the same way that you would drink the water. You just, if there's no water in it, there's nothing to drink, and you'll fill it up. What? Oh. I passed it at some point. Don't tell me it's on the other side of the river. Oh, it's in the river, isn't it? No? What? Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's say, what the hell? You can kind of run. If you hold X and run... Iron leg, reed. Even if you know how. If you're not playing with friends, then you want to go ahead and read everything you can. Because even if you've already read it, it could raise that skill. Like armor smithing or whatever the skill happens to be. But we just got schematics to build a sniper rifle, which is quite cool. And a friggin' bear, that's not the kind of animal I want. Even though he would have all the hide I need, I have no way of killing that bear. No way at all. I could try, but I would die. That's like, I'm positive. You can die to a bear even when you are higher level, if you're not careful. You just need a good hunting rifle and about 4 or 5 shots to the face. With that, you could take on a bear. On the way to the house, I'm going to go ahead and get me some yucca fruits by killing cactus. Doesn't matter what size the cacti is, same amount of hits. So, just depends on what kind of tool you're using for how good you're going to break it. And right now it's taking more hits because I have no stamina, so... If you have more stamina, everything takes less hits. Same for if you're mining or anything. That's why I'm walking. So we have plenty of antibiotics for a long time. Like, we don't have to worry about that. If you get infected and you take antibiotics, you're actually immune to infection for 24 hours after that. So that's pretty cool. I used to think that, like, clubs were pretty useless until I found that they do way more damage to a zombie than this stone axe, for example. So they're not useless. If I get plenty of this, then I can make a bunch of stone clubs at night. That's for sure. That used all my stamina for a little bit there. We're alright. We'll be good. How much yucca did I get? 16. You're overheating. Yeah. I also need rocks, but I don't like beating on those rocks. If I'm gonna hit a rock, I wanna get metal also. If you're overheating and you're next to water, jump in the damn water. Like, I'm about to get in the water just to cool off. Alright, 24 is plenty for now. Alright. See, I think the forge takes like 50 stone. See my temperature just dropping? That's great. Submerge your whole body, and I should be more than 86% wet. No? Alright, no longer overheating. Here, a zombie or something. Yeah, punching it's not gonna do a whole lot. It's not gonna hurt you, but it's not gonna deal much damage to it. I hate the stone axe days, man. The first, you know, week or so of the game where all you have is a stone axe for a tool. These days kinda suck, but you know, we'll get past these days. When this is your only tool, it's like you don't really want to break into every house you see because it takes so long to bust some doors. If the door is like reinforced with metal, you don't want to jack with that. If it's reinforced with wood, this tool's just fine. But yeah, some of them have metal plates on them and stuff, and there's like no way you're gonna really bust that door open in any good amount of time. You will eventually, but to me, the stuff that you find in there is not worth it. Is not worth all that time. Wish I could find another pig. Right in the head. Right in the kisser. Anything good? Eventually zombies start getting good stuff. Once your scavenging skill gets way up. That's one thing on my last long life that I have where I'm like level 50 something or 60 something. The first thing I did was max out my scavenging. Instead of just searching to do it, that's what I was pumping my points into. I couldn't tell you for a fact if it's worth it or not, but I was doing that, and I started finding good schematics and stuff on zombies. So then I'd just go out and kill zombies and find decent stuff. Starting to get thirsty. And a little hungry. I'll just make sure to get plenty of these on the way home. Plenty of cactus. And we'll be able to eat the yucca fruits, and we're gonna boil water here soon. I'm like really thirsty, but we just need to get there and boil that water. It is not worth drinking this lake water, getting the chance of getting sick, because it's a really good chance. Like, you will most likely get sick. And when you get sick, you get dysentery. And it doesn't just go away, I don't think. Sometimes you're lucky and it'll go away, but you usually need to either make the right kind of tea for it, which I think is the yellow flowers. Make tea out of those, or you need vitamins. It really takes a lot of yucca fruit to fill up, that's why I'm getting so many. I have 26. That might actually fill me up, maybe. 30, maybe, something like that will fill you up. We're not far from the house, so that's why I'm not in a big hurry. We got about 3, 4, or 5 minutes, something like that, before zombies get fast. It's not the worst thing if you get stuck out at night. It can be. If multiple zombies see you, you can get in a lot of trouble. But really, if a zombie sees you, just fight him just like you would during the day. He'll run at you, though. Ooh, a rabbit just died. Does a rabbit always die when I'm close to home? Right there. Dang it. Dang it, it's like I'm missing the rabbit. There we go. I didn't get much off of him. Got a few. We now have a total of 10 hide, which is decent. We just need 10 more. And then with that and the rest of the stuff we have, we can actually make a forge. So maybe tomorrow when we go out, we'll be able to do that. Maybe. Get up here, crouch, pick up all these other frames. Go up a step, pick up that frame. They can no longer reach us. They can still tear the house down. They can literally break this house down. Haven't had it happen in one of these houses, but they sure the hell can. So let's get some water boiling. I'll show you how to do that. First, you put the cooking pot in there. Then you put a fuel source, which I'm going to use coal. I'm going to save my wood. I'm just going to use half this coal. If you hit square, it only picks up half. If you hit square to put something down, it only drops one at a time. So you can put however many you want, but I'm going to do that many. And now to craft the water, you click bottled water, max it out, and hit up. And that will take it out of your inventory, put it in the fire, and start boiling water. Currently, we can make boiled meat. It literally, for some reason, disintegrates the bottle, though. Like, you lose the water jar. Which is okay, but you do lose the water jar. So far, all I've been eating are canned meats. If you actually eat cooked meat, your wellness starts going up. And when your wellness goes up, your health and stamina go up. I don't know what the max is, maybe 120 on each, I don't know. But, you can get your wellness and stuff up, and that's nice. Let's go drink some water. And we should also be able to boil meat, which I hate, but whatever. Let's drink some of this water real quick. Drink. Because we were really thirsty, so I thought. Yeah, we were. This just actually fills up your water damn good because it's fresh water. Alright, now it says that we're pretty hungry, so let's go ahead and just start eating these yucca fruits. Yummy, this is the fun part. That will probably about do it for this video, though. You guys are going to be bored the rest of the night, I'm sure, as I am. So we'll cut that part out. I hope you guys are enjoying my series. Let me know if you have any questions or anything like that. And please leave a comment if you liked it. Give me a thumbs up if you could and sub if you haven't. And I will see you guys on the next video. So thanks for watching. Om nom nom nom. Om nom nom nom.